Disgraced former Anne Arundel County Executive John Leopold wants to return to public office, but first, he has to clear his name. He's now fighting to overturn his conviction on criminal misconduct in office. I-Team reporter David Collins has more on the story from Annapolis.
Lawyers for former County Executive John Leopold argue while his behavior in office could be viewed as inappropriate, it does not constitute a crime.
This conduct is not criminal conduct, and we have made that point at the trial court, and we made it again today.
Leopold stands convicted on two counts of misconduct in office. He ordered his security detail to distribute campaign signs, remove his opponent's signs, collect fundraising checks, and make dossiers on political rivals. He ordered county employees to empty his urine from his catheter bag when he went back to work following back surgery. His lawyers want the conviction overturned and for the judges to remove a ban that keeps him from running for office. The three-judge special appeals court panel heard defense arguments that Leopold's due process rights were violated. The state slapped him with misfeasance, not malfeasance, in office charges.
It does make a difference because it was actually an element of the offense as charged by the state. And they made the decision to include that, which obviously means they have an obligation to prove it.
Webster's defines malfeasance as illegal or dishonest activity by a public official. Misfeasance means the performance of a lawful action in an illegal or improper manner. The state countered, labeling the term as not essential. They say Leopold willfully and corruptly abused his position of authority over subordinates. His, quote, bizarre commands, end quote, were unlawful. The judges quizzed both sides. What's the tipping point? Is it a crime when he actually needed medical assistance? Is it a crime because the orders were distasteful? What's the ill motive? The panel also used analogies. Is it a crime if your boss orders you to get their lunch or work overtime when they know it's your 50th wedding anniversary and you have special plans?
Judges ask a lot of questions. It doesn't necessarily tell you what they're thinking or how they view the arguments.
That was David Collins reporting. Now, there's no indication when the court will rule. The deadline to file to run for office this year is February 25th.